Hello everyone. Welcome back in English class. Students, today I want to talk to you, everyone, on a very important topic. So, what do you understand by the word life? What is the meaning of life for all of you? And we are doing always and always good in life to do or to achieve something great. You always used to get lessons from your parents, from your teachers, from everyone that do something, do that, try to achieve your goal, try to become a teacher, doctor, engineer, CA, so many options you all have in front of you. So why you want to be a successful man in life? Why exactly? Why you want to achieve your goals, your dreams, your career? Why exactly is it important to choose your career? What exactly? What is the meaning of all this? We are going to school, we have to study there, and afterward we have to join the college. We all need a good degree in our hand so that with the help of that degree, with the help of our education, we can move ahead in life. We can climb up the stairs of the life one by one. But at the end of the day, what exactly our soul need? What is the diet of our soul and our mind? We need contentedness. We need satisfaction. And that satisfaction, how we can get, how we can achieve that satisfaction? Because if you are not satisfied with yourself, you really have achieved something big in life later on. After 20 years, you would become a doctor and you are a very renowned surgeon in the life. You become something very good in life and you achieved everything. But at the end of the day, if you are not contented with yourself, then these all things, your achievements, your goal, your successes, your dreams, these all things are in vain. They are of no use. We need our mind, our body, they just need a contentment. And how we can get that contentment, that satisfaction? By earning more and more money, by earning a very lavish life, by purchasing good cars, by building up a good mansion? No, it's not. It's not the reality. It's not the hidden meaning of life. It's not the real meaning of life. What is the real meaning of life that today we are going to read with the help of a beautiful poem written by a renowned famous writer of our India, Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore, the name is itself enough. Needs no introduction, but still we'll read something about him also, and further we will discuss a beautiful poem written by him, The Last Bargain. And what is inside the poem exactly? What is there inside the poem? What is the theme of the poem? Let me tell you. The Last Bargain poem, it has a very powerful message, very deep message for every one of us. What is the message? And this message is very apt for today's materialistic life. Materialistic life means everybody wants good shoes, good house, or good mansion, or very brand new equipments, gadgets at our house, good AC, or everybody wants branded clothes, branded cars, branded bikes, everything. So we want, our lust want more and more and more every day. So is this a meaning of life? No, exactly not. You can earn all these things, you can collect all these things, but these things will not give you any kind of contentment, any kind of satisfaction. What is the real meaning of satisfaction? Where exactly you will get the exact meaning of life? Find out. Come on. Let's talk about Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore was born in Calcutta on 6th of May 1861. He received his education at his own home and later at University College, London. He was a poet, dramatist, novelist, short story writer, a philosopher, and a nation builder. He founded a school at Shantiniketan in West Bengal, which later expanded into an international university known as the Vishwa Bharati. He even created a new form of music, which is known as Rabindra Sangeet. He is the author of India's national anthem, Jan Gan Man. He died in Calcutta on 7th of August 1941. First of all, let's start reading of this poem. A bargain is an agreement in which both parties promise to do something for each other. Someone is looking for work, waiting to be hired. He strikes a bargain but thinks it worthless. He tries twice again but doesn't like either. Finally, in the last bargain, when he is hired for nothing, whatever, he is happy as never before. What is the bargain and why is it the best? Let's find out. "Come and hire me," I cried, "while in the morning I was walking on the stone-paved road. Sword in hand, the king came in his chariot. He held my hand and said, 'I'll hire you with my power.' But his power counted for naught, and he went away in his chariot. In the heat of the midday, the houses stood with shut doors. I wandered along the crooked lane. An old man came out with his bag of gold. He pondered and said, 'I'll hire you with my money.' He weighed his coin one by one, but I turned away. It was evening. The garden hedge was all flower. The fair maid came out and said, 'I will hire you with a smile.' Her smile paled and melted into tears, and she went back alone into the dark. The sun glistened on the sand, and the sea waves broke waywardly. A child sat playing with shells. He raised his head and seemed to know me and said, 'I hire you with nothing.' And from henceforward, that bargain struck in child's play made me a free man." Written by Rabindranath Tagore. So students, this poem is about someone looking for a job. However, he wants to be hired without losing his freedom. Isn't it interesting that you wanted to be hired by someone side by side? You don't want to lose your freedom. So the poet tells us that he received offers from the rich, the powerful, and the beautiful. However, he turned them all down. And at last he met an innocent child and he immediately accepted his offer. So students, what is the meaning of, first of all, let's discuss what is the meaning of bargain. So bargain is a kind of agreement in which both the parties promise to do something for each other. It's like an agreement. So where you would agree to do something for a person, and that person would also agree to give you something back for your work. So that is called a bargain. So here, someone is looking for a work. A man we have here in our poem. He is looking for a work, waiting to be hired. So he is there and he is waiting to be hired. And he strikes a bargain but thinks it worthless. He tries twice again, but doesn't like either. So different kind of offer he gets here, and he denied to everyone. Finally, in the last bargain, when he is hired for nothing, whatever, he is happy as never before. So at the end of the poem, this man will be hired by an innocent child, and the agreement settles in this way that he is hired for nothing. So it's very interesting. We'll find out later. So what is the bargain and why is it the best? So, what was the last bargain? Let's read and discuss everything line by line. Come and hire me, I cried. I was walking on the stone-paved road. Sword in hand, the king came in his chariot. So the king's proposal, the first offer, came from a king early in the morning. And he had more power than wealth. So king, the man was walking on a stone-paved road. And the stone-paved road, it shows that life is not equal for all the person. And life is not even for all the time. Life is always full of ups and downs. It's a mixture of ups and downs. So the man was walking on the stone-paved road and he was crying. He was saying to everyone that, come on, come and hire me. So he held who? The king. The king, he was coming in a chariot and he held my hand and said, I will hire you with my power. So the first offer, that man, it came from a king side early in the morning, and the king, he had more power than wealth. So he offered the man his power in return for the man's labor. That I have power, you give your labor to me and I'll give my power to you. The man, however, felt that the king's might was not worth much. So he refused. So it's written there that his power counted for naught. And he went away in his chariot. In the heat of midday, the houses stood with shut doors. I wandered along the crooked lane. An old man came out with his bag of gold. What is the meaning of crooked lane? Crooked means bent out of shape or curving around sharply. So this is the meaning of crooked, means something bent or curved in shape. So crooked lane, he said that he was roaming here and there along the crooked lane, and an old man came out with his bag of gold and he pondered and said, so pondered meaning very carefully, very intensely and very, very in a very caring manner. So the man said, I will hire you with my money. And he weighed his coins one by one, but I turned away. So next was the turn of a rich man. Second offer came in the midway when it was really very hot. It was noon time. An old man offered him a lot of gold in return of his labor. The man was not much impressed. The wealth did not attract him, and so he refused this rich man's offer as well. Then it was evening. The garden hedge was all aflower. The fair maid came out and said, I will hire you with a smile. Her smile paled and melted into tears, and she went back alone into the dark. So next turn came. It was of a beautiful It was from a side of beautiful lady. So then it was evening time. There was a natural beauty all around. There were flowers in the hedge. And a beautiful girl, she came to the man. And she gave a very pretty smile to him. She offered to give the man her smiles in return of his labor. However, the man again found that her happiness was only sorrow in disguise. So he again denied that offer too, and he moved forward. Next, the sun glistened on the sand. Glisten means the sun was shining on the sand, and the sea waves broke waywardly. And the meaning of wayward means in a very disobedient, in a very willful way. So here he said, a child sat playing with shells, and he raised his head and seemed to know me and said, I hire you with nothing. And from henceforward, that bargain stuck in child's play made me a free man. And next was the turn of a small innocent child. and this is the last proposal. So ultimately, the man came to the seashore, and there he found a child playing with shells. Because it's a seashore scene, so the child was playing with the shells. And the child offered to take his services in return for nothing. The child said, "I'll hire you with nothing. I'm hiring you, and in return, I'll give you nothing." The man accepted the offer immediately, because while playing with the child, he was still a free man. So this is the end of the poem. Let's discuss further what is the hidden meaning here. So students, it's a very famous poem written by Rabindranath Tagore. And here we have observed that the poem opens with the speaker. He was walking on a stone paved road, and the stone paved road also symbolizes that life is not smooth for anyone. The man was asking out to hire him to everyone, and he came across a king who was riding on his chariot with a sword in one hand. The king offered him to hire the narrator with his power and authority. However, the power of the king had no value for the narrator, and thus he moved ahead. Then, during the midday, the speaker wandered along on a twisted lane comprising the houses with the shut doors. Then an old man with the bag of gold came out, and he also tried to hire that man. But the money will be soon spent and cannot buy us everlasting happiness. So therefore, the man also turned out from this man. Then during the evening, the narrator passed a garden hedge which was covered by various flowers. A beautiful maiden came out, and she offered to hire him with her flattening smile. However, again, since beauty took a short lift and would soon fade away, so nothing remains in life in the same condition. So he also rejected her. Upon which the maiden, beautiful flattening smile, she melted into tears, and she then went back alone into the dark night. Next morning, sea coast shone golden. The sea waves broke in a rebellious manner, because they were waywardly, they were disobediently moving. So a child symbolizes that child is a symbol of cheerfulness, innocent and contentment. Child was sitting on the sun glistening coast, and he was innocently playing with the seashells. He offered to hire the speaker with nothing, and the narrator, he was attracted by the flawless character of the child, and he was overwhelmed by the simplicity, the innocence, which did not give materialistic pleasures but was more and more satisfying always. So thus the bargain was struck by a child who hired the speaker for nothing. Through this poem, so it's significant that power, money or lust could not free the speaker. We cannot make ourselves free by using our power, by using our money, by using our lust. However, the power of innocence had the ability to break away our bondage, and the child had the power to enslave him. So see, the poem has a very beautiful message for all of us. Money cannot be everlasting, and our beauty, it can also later on will destroy. But the innocence, the simplicity, the contentness, this will remain with us forever and ever. So always and always be true to yourself and be true to every other one. Now it's time to discuss the question answers of this poem. The first question that we have here is, who is the speaker in the poem? So we can give this answer here, that who is the speaker? A man looking for his employer is the speaker. So a man, he is looking for a job, is the speaker here. The next we have question number 2. The king, sword in hand, suggests. So the king has a sword in his hand. So what do you understand? What is the meaning of this hand, a sword in hand here? So is it the symbol of power, wealth, or more power than wealth? So what is our answer here? It's a symbol of power, because it is already mentioned in our poem clearly. Next is, the old man offered the speaker a lot of money. Why did he turn down the offer? So why exactly? The old man offered a bag of gold to him, but still he refused for his offer. So the man did not need money. He was not looking for money. He valued his freedom more than becoming a slave for gold. He assumed at that moment that you would give me a gold and you will make your slave to me. So that is why he denied his offer. Next, find in the poem lines that match the following. Read both one after another. The first one we have here, I have nothing to give you except goodwill and cheer. So what we can write here, I hire you with nothing. Okay. Second is, her happiness was no more than sorrow in disguise. So we have done this already. Her smile, the lady's smile, paled and melted into tears. Next is, the king's might was not worth much, but his power counted for naught. This is the answer we have here. Next question, number 5 we have. How did the speaker feel after talking to the child on the bench? How did the speaker feel after the after talking to the child on the beach? So how did the speaker feel? This also we have done. The speaker felt after meeting the child that he would get satisfaction, joy, freedom, simplicity, everything. So students, here I assume that you all have understood the poem very well. You all have got the meaning of the poem, the hidden meaning, and you all have enjoyed it to the fullest. So students, we will meet in our next session with our next topic. Till then, stay safe, stay inside your house, take care of yourself and your family also. Thank you.